Endless thanks and praise be to Allah Almighty, who created us and all things. And may His peace and blessings be upon His beloved Messenger. Bediuzzaman Said Nursi was born in 1873 in the village of Nurs, in the district of Hizan and sub-district of Isparit, in the province of Bitlis in eastern Turkey. His fortunate father, Mirza Efendi, was so God-fearing and dignified that rather than having to take things from others, he himself grazed their animals. He would even muzzle the cattle on the journey to and from home so that they should not eat from other people's fields, thus making their produce unlawful. In this way, Mirza lived an active, self-respecting life, certain of feeding his children only what was lawful. The young Sayyid's mother, Nuria Hanum, began her son's education when he was only a year old. She had a powerful influence on the child, for when 80 years of age, Bediuzzaman said this about his mother: "In my lifetime of 80 years, I have received instruction from 80 people. Yet I swear that the truest and most unshakable lessons I have received, which have always retained their freshness, have been those inculcated in me by my late mother. For they were as though planted in my very nature and physical beings like seeds. I see now that the other instruction has been constructed on those seeds. This means that the lessons my late mother instilled in my nature and spirit when I was 1 year old were fundamental seeds among the great truths that I now see at the age of 80. I see with complete sincerity, for instance, that it was from the compassion I learned from my mother's conduct and manner that I have taken compassion as the most important of the four main principles of my way, and kindness and sympathy, which also constitute the greatest truth of the risale-i." Bediuzzaman remained under the guidance of his dignified father and kindly mother till he was 9 years old. The lessons most deeply implanted in him he learnt in his father's house. There then awoke in him the desire to study, and he went in succession to the medres, or religious school, in the village of Tar, to the summer pastures of the Hizan Sheikh, and to Nurshin. However, he could not endure to be dominated and spoken down to by some of the other students, and returned home. Sometime following that, he dreamt of the Prophet Muhammed, upon whom be blessings and peace, and was told in reply to his request for knowledge, "Knowledge of the Quran will be granted on the condition that you ask no questions to anyone of my community." Fired with enthusiasm by this auspicious dream, he requested his parents' permission to continue his studies. After remaining a short period in Gevash, he set off for Dol Bezit and the Medres Sheikh Muhammad Jalali. Here he studied intensively for 3 months and completed the course that normally could be completed only in 20 or so years. He committed to memory the basic texts of 80 books and received the spiritual effulgence of the local saint and wali, Ahmed Ihan. From there, the young Sayyid went to Sheikh Mehmed Emin Efendi in Bitlis, and after a short stay, travelled on to his brother, Mola Abdullah, in Shirvan, and from there he went to Siirt to Mola Fetur Efendi. These two latter scholars tested Bediuzzaman on the subjects he had studied, and he replied perfectly to all their questions. In Siirt, he memorised in a week the four-volume work Jam al-Jawami. He also memorised verses from Makamat al-Harira by simply reading them once. These learned teachers were left in astonishment at the level of intelligence and power of memory they found combined in one person. From Siirt, Bediuzzaman moved on to the village of Tilo, Aydınlar. Here he stayed for 3 months in a small domed building on a hilltop outside the village, Kubiye Hasya, where he memorised an Arabic lexicon called the Kamus al-Okyanus, as far as the 14th letter of the alphabet, Sin. He used to give the pieces of food in the soup he received every day to the ants, while he himself made do with bread and the liquid. When asked the reason for this, he would reply, "I have observed that they have a social life and work together diligently, and I want to help them as a reward for their republicanism." While in Tilo, Bediuzzaman dreamt that Sheikh Abd al-Qadir Gelani told him to go to Mustafa Pasha, the chief of the Miran tribe, to advise him to give up his tyranny, perform the obligatory prayers, and command what is right, otherwise he was to kill him. So he set off for the Miran tribe, Because the tribal leader knew of Mullah Said's fame, he told him that he would set up a contest between him and the religious scholars of Jizra. "If you defeat the scholars," he said, "I'll do what you say and perform the prayers. But if you can't beat them, I'll throw you in the river." He arranged for the contest to be held at the place called Banihan on the banks of the Tigris. Bediuzzaman answered correctly the 40 questions prepared by the scholars and won the contest. Whereupon Mustafa Pasha gave him the Mauser rifle he had promised him and began to perform the prayers. In Mardin and Bitlis, Bediuzzaman was involved in a number of political and social matters that were contrary to Islam. For instance, on one occasion he opposed some officials who were drinking alcohol and gave them a stern warning. Following this, he was exiled to Bitlis by the governor. In the 2 years he remained in Bitlis, Bediuzzaman memorized around 40 works on the Islamic sciences, including Matali, Mawakif, and Mirkat. Every day he would recite a portion of them from memory, and it would take 3 months to go through the lot. On the invitation of Hasan Pasha and Tahir Pasha, he left Bitlis for Van, where he began the study of the modern physical sciences. Through his own efforts, he learned such sciences as history, geography, mathematics, geology, physics, chemistry, and astronomy. He held scholarly debates with teachers of chemistry and geography. While in Van, Tahir Pasha showed him some shocking news in a newspaper. In the British Parliament, the Secretary of the Colonies, Gladstone, had held up a copy of the Holy Quran and said, "So long as the Muslims have the Quran, we will be unable to dominate them. We must either take it from them or make them lose their love of it." This provoked an overwhelming response in Bediuzzaman, causing him to declare, "I shall prove and demonstrate to the world that the Quran is an undying and inextinguishable sun." In 1907, Bediuzzaman left to Istanbul to win support for the university-type medrese he wanted to found in Van and Diyarbakir, called the Medrese Zehra. He rented a room, Sheikh Jihan, in the Fatih district, and hung a notice on his door which said, "Here all questions are answered, all problems are solved, but no questions are asked." The famous scholars of Istanbul and groups of students came to visit him and ask him various questions, all of which he replied to unhesitatingly. It was at the time that Istanbul Ulma gave him the name of Bediuzzaman, which means wonder of the age. Bediuzzaman was arrested during the 31st of March incident in 1909 and sent before the court-martial. The chief judge of the court, Hushrid Pasha, accused him angrily, "You too wanted the Sharia mixed up in this affair." Displaying not a trace of fear, Bediuzzaman unwaveringly replied, "If I had 1,000 lives, I would be ready to sacrifice all of them for a single matter of the Sharia. For the Sharia is the source of prosperity and happiness and true justice and virtue. But not like those who revolted want it. Yes, I have committed 11.5 crimes." He then went on to describe all the services he had performed for the country and asked the court if those were crimes so that he had been sent before it. He delivered an awe-inspiring defense, following which he was acquitted. Offering no thanks, he turned on his heel and strode out of the court shouting, "Long live hell for all tyrants!" Bediuzzaman did not remain long in Istanbul. He set out for Van by way of Batum and Tiflis. In Tiflis, he climbed Sheikh Saman Tepe, the hill overlooking the city, when he was approached by a Russian policeman. The following exchange ensued, which began with the policeman asking, "Why are you studying the land with such attention?" Bediuzzaman replied, "I'm planning my medrese." "Where are you from?" "I'm from Bitlis." "But this is Tiflis." "Bitlis is one of Tiflis's brothers." The policeman was bewildered. "What do you mean?" Bediuzzaman explained, "Three lights are beginning to be revealed one after the other in Asia and the world of Islam. While with you, three layers of darkness will start to recede one over the other. This veil of despotism shall be rent. It will shrink back, and I shall come and build my medrese here." This only increased the policeman's bewilderment. "I'm sorry for you," he said. "I'm astonished that you should entertain such a hope." "And I'm astonished at your not understanding," replied Bediuzzaman.